After discussing about clothes and fibers, all the children went to Mohan's house. Mohan's father works in a textile factory. All the children were very excited to meet him. On reaching Mohan's house, everyone met Mohan's mother. Hey, all the children together today? How are you all?
We are good, auntie.
Are the preparations for the festival done?
Yes, auntie. I even got a new dress sewed for my doll by my aunt.
Meanwhile, Mohan's father came home from work. Everyone said hello to him.
Hey kids, it was great seeing all of you together today.
Father, we have all come to see you. We are keen to know about the production of clothes.
Yes, uncle. We want to know how the fabric is made. It is made in your factory, isn't it?
Yes, Sunaina. I am coming back from the factory right now. I feel good that you all want to know about the production of clothes. Well, first of all, do you know what cloth is made up of?
Yes, uncle. My auntie told me that cloth is made up of fibers. And we can get these fibers from plants and animals.
Oh, wow, Sunaina. You are absolutely right. And these fibers are of different types, from which different fabrics are made.
Yes, uncle. Like cotton, jute, woolen, synthetic, etc.
You all know a lot. Cotton cloth is made where I work. So, I will tell you in detail about how cotton cloth is manufactured. Okay?
Okay, uncle.
Cotton cloth is made from cotton. It is cultivated in many parts of our country. Cotton is hand-picked from cotton plants. It is then combed to remove its fibers. This process is known as cotton ginning. With the help of a large comb-like device, the cotton swab is made. Earlier, people used to do this work by hand, but nowadays it is also done by machines.
Then how do we make clothes from fiber?
I'll tell you, kids. Just wait a minute. I'll tell you everything.
Mohan's mother was in the preparation to light earthen lamps to decorate the house. Mohan's father brings a cotton ball and gives it to the children.
Children, this is the ball made of cotton. Come on, try to make wicks out of this for the lamps.
Okay, uncle.
The way you all are crushing the cotton between your hands to make it as a thread is known as spinning. Cotton yarns are made by spinning the cotton fibers. When we have to do a lot of spinning, we do this with the help of machines. A large needle-like device called a spindle converts cotton into yarn. The cloth is woven from the yarn.
Wait. Like my grandmother makes sweaters for me? Like that?
Absolutely right, Subir. There are two types of weaving. Have you ever looked at a mat carefully?
Yes, uncle. The mat is made by joining the reeds.
Sameena is right. Just as you see a net of reeds in the mat, in the same way, clothes are made by weaving a net of threads.
To make a net by weaving each piece of thread would take a lot of time to make fabrics.
No, Subir. A device called a loom is used to do this type of weaving. This device is also operated by hand and it can be operated by machines too.
Really? So fabric is made quickly by this machine?
Absolutely.
Thanks, uncle. I enjoyed learning all this about fibers and fabric. I did not know that the clothes we wear are made up of such small fibers.
Children, not only this. Our Bapu, that is Gandhiji, had made the British rule very weak on the basis of fabric and khadi.
How did he do it, Dad?
Bapu himself boycotted English clothes and used his spinning wheel, which is used to make the fabric khadi. The Swadeshi wave was then swept across the country and everyone boycotted English clothes.
Wow, that's amazing. The British must have missed sixes. I really enjoyed listening to this story, Father. I will read about it in more detail.
Come on, kids. You all had a long day today. Now, let's have the scrumptious food that I have made for you all.
Okay, Auntie.